I am Brian Deacon, and I play Peter in Lion, Witch, Wardrobe.
Oh God.
Some of the new freshmen, or even just the sophomores that have been new to the show, like Naomi's a sophomore, and she's been hilarious to be around. Her spunk's awesome. Cody's been hilarious. Like, we got to the final show, and he said, "Let us give the Lord's blessing." And then he holds up a whole head of cabbage, like he's praying to the cabbage. He's like, "Let us eat." And then he just crunches a huge bite out of the lettuce. Like, he's hilarious. And then Cabot's so energetic. He had pre-workout for the first time before, like, one of our shows, and he was just feeling jazz the entire time. It was so funny. Ainsley and I have been getting along well with Sass, and so we'll go back and forth. Throwing snow in her face is an absolute blast. I love it every time. I've accidentally got some stuck in her eye before, and then she complained about it, and I went, ha. But it's just really funny because we have a silly dynamic that's just been growing. Same with Tia. Ella as well. She's so joyful, and then to see her flip into like the witch, which is just like this chaotically just like energetic but like scheming villain, and just seeing her do that has been really fun.
Happy opening night! Yeah!
Hey guys. Like, it's actually comfortable. Like, I'm not gonna fall over. I mean, I'm not gonna move super fast. But other than that...
As fast as your hips can carry you?
That's almost scarier.
I don't want to bend it.
Yeah, like, I'm out.
Hey, that was
I love it.
I would rather walk around like this all the time.
Yeah, this is legitimately...
Wow, we're like the greatest showmen.
Dear Lord, through this day, through all the time you've given us, please keep us warm right now.
Please!
That's you, Sarah. Thank you so much for the time we've get to had. That we've had to create such a magical show that tells the story of your son and the love that you have for us. We are here tonight to serve you first. Nothing else is in the way of us to serve you and serve this community of people who have come to see such a magical show. The show has power, and it is up to us to display your love for them in a magical and fantastical way that Prof Sarver has led us to do through whatever methods that he's got us to do. Continue to bless the show, continue to keep us safe, continue to heal anything that needs to be healed physically, mentally, or spiritually. A lot for Sarver, physically. And just bring this cast together and give us energy. This is opening night, and we're about to have a blast.
Yeah!
Alright.
Amen.
This and so much more in your son's name. Amen.
Amen.
Alright, I want to see you guys get wild. Let's go!
I can't!
I love theater and doing these productions because of the community that we as the actors and directors and anyone else involved in the show process get to build. There's a community and a family unit that is created that is unique.
My name is Shelby Black and I play Aslan.
The prophecy is to be fulfilled. You,
your brother, and your sister shall sit on those thrones.
It's meant a lot, definitely, being able to be in a show that I really like with a bunch of new people and people that I've known for a long time. I really felt a deep connection with the cast, and I was very happy to be a part of it, to basically make this legacy with Narnia and ONU Theater. So I felt very honored and very happy to be a part. I had already watched all of the movies. I'm actually a huge fan of Narnia. And then I have read most of the books as well. But I think the inspiration that I took for my character was more from the Bible than from the actual movies. I was like, if I'm gonna be portraying essentially Jesus, I wanna do it as well as I can. So as I took the knowledge that I already had from my biblical studies, and I was like, I want to embody that as much as possible. I want to be grace, I want to be peace, I want to be mercy, but then I also want to be strict, you know. So I tried to embody that as much as possible.
My name is Ella Carter, and I'm the White Witch. Theater is one of the reasons I came to Olivet, so I was very excited, and I've done theater for a while now. It makes me really happy, and it just gives me joy, and so I really wanted to be a part of it here. I got to sit in on a class in April. It just seemed really fun and really, oh my gosh, it was already a community. I could see it, and I was like, oh my gosh, let me be a part of this. I love the community. I'm so thankful for it because, it feels really inclusive, and I really feel welcomed. It makes me really happy, and I'm really glad to be a part of it. And so yeah, this is my first show. I think it's been fun. It's been fun. It's been nice. I really like everyone. They've been super nice to me, and so that's good.
I'm Prof Sarver, and I am the director of ONU Theater, and I was the director of The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Don't even worry about it. I'm really nervous.
Yes, okay.
Okay, are you ready?
Okay.
Do you want to put your arms out or no? Do you want to just look at it?
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Okay. You can open your eyes.
Why?
Oh my gosh, guys, thank you so much! This is such a great gift! When we saw that, we thought Prop Sarver.
Yeah.
We also thought Adriana, she has one too.
Yeah, you guys are
20. Wow, thank you so much.
No,
this is really, I'd like to thank my mom, my dad, and the Academy for this award.
Awesome. With great power comes great responsibility. So
thanks, guys.
Awesome.
We did good.
I noticed the camaraderie of the cast grow to a depth that I never could have imagined. And that was a delight to see. They formed this family bond. I mean, that usually happens in theater, but this one, whoa, it was very deep. And I realized personally, like as a director, the less control I try to have, the more things happen the way they should. And that was something I noticed in my directing throughout the process. And also, so to put those two together, I really value the family feeling that happens within a theater production. And I need to let go sometimes and let that happen organically, because it'll end up getting deeper when I'm not trying to force it to happen. And I didn't. Like this time I was kind of hands off with that, and the students just took off and loved each other.
My favorite things about Prof Sarver is that she can literally do anything. Anything she sets her mind to, it will be accomplished and it will be done well. No matter what the process looks like during, the end product is always amazing and it blows me away every single time for sure. And then the confidence that comes with it, her confidence in herself, even if it's not as internal as she would like, the portrayed confidence and self-esteem that she has, I aspire to have that on a daily basis. So she has definitely been a role model for me as a person and as a director, to be able to be solely confident in yourself no matter what anyone says, and to try your hardest to accomplish your goals.
All right,
let's go.
This is it. This is the final show. Yeah. We have done so much. Holy crap. We woke up so early the past 2 days. Oh my gosh.
4 a.m.
Not me.
Go!
This is it. We have had some great runs. We have had some legendary moments. I'm gonna say that because it just sounds right. But above all, I just want to say that I am so grateful for each and every one of you. Every single freshman year, I am floored at the ability and the skill and the level you are coming in at, because I was not there when I came in as a transfer. So you astound me.
Tonight, this time, when we get to the end of the show, it is time to leave Narnia. But you are all kings and queens. Listen, I did not say this enough to you all this semester, but I love you guys so much. You have no idea. You have no idea how much I love you all.
It was so difficult watching the production. I mean, it was wonderful watching the production, but it was so difficult because I knew that I was not staying. And I just saw, I just really love them a lot.
We have gone from being strangers to being a cast to being a family. That is something that I don't think anyone else on this campus can say. Maybe football can say they're a family.
Not like this. Not like this.
Right.
They're liars.
So, I know that I've said things, but again, just like Prof. Sarper, I cannot express how grateful I am to know each and every one of you, whether it is little or small. I have gotten to know everyone or see everyone do something absolutely incredible on that stage, and we get to do it one last time. And so, again, thank you all for also bearing the cold, but also bearing with me, and I love each and every one of you as a brother or sister, a daughter of Eve, or a son of Eve. And let's rock this show one last time.
Yeah. Oh, let's do it. I'm so proud of you guys.
All right, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for this moment, for this community, for this family of people that has just been brought together for you, by you. There's nothing else we can say or believe that would be the ulterior. For you are the core of this group, you are the core of this show, and you are the core of this school. You will continue to astound us all with each other and with everything else that comes into our life. I can't express enough words of gratitude to you or this cast, and I also cannot express the amount of growth either that each person has had to take. But through that, we've gotten to this moment. We get to do this one last time, and let this be our best show yet. Let us do this in your name, and just allow us to love every moment and just really love you. Thank you. I don't have many other words in my head right now besides, dang, it's cold, but we love you. and we love each other because of you. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And all God's people say,
Amen! Amen.
Last show, best show, y'all!
Yeah. 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 For the sake of cars, let's back up a little bit. I don't wanna, yeah, I don't wanna act out yet.
Cami, you drink!
No!
No!
It's fine. Alright, come on.
Alright.
Here we go.
Alright.
Get in here.
No, that is.
We are dogs.
Let's screw this crap up. All right. Here we go. All right.
We are dogs, yeah. And we gotta let the dogs out. Yeah. Let's go.
We always achieve what we set out to accomplish.
Our brother is right. I suggest that before we pursue the white stag further, that we remove our crowds so that they do not become damaged in our thinking.
I agree. Let's leave them here until we return.
This lamp on the post looks strangely upon me. Has not seen it before. In a tree.
I feel the same. It seemeth to me a strange adventure lies on this side of the lamppost.
Well then, in the name of Aslan, let us take the adventure that shall fall to us.
Wait for us, good sister and brother.
Brother, this lamppost, it wrote strangely upon me just as it did with Lucy and Edmund.
I feel its peculiar effects as well.
Where are we?
You're in the thicket, of course.
No, we're not. We're in a wardrobe.
Wardrobe?
The wardrobe! I completely forgot about it.
Yes, me too. The room hasn't changed at all, and the floor has hardly moved.
Come on, you two. Perhaps we can still be inside for dinner.
It must be time to leave, Peter.
I suppose it is.
Peter, do you ever think we'll find our way back to Narnia again?
We're lucky, Susan. We're very lucky. Yes, the children will find their way back here again. Perhaps not through the wardrobe, but there are other paths that lead to Narnia. Oh yes, they will find their way back here again someday. For once a king in Narnia, always a king. Once a queen, always a queen. It is important that they return, for good people need good rulers, and good rulers need good people. That, perhaps, is the deepest magic of all.
Prof Sarver, good luck. I know you're gonna do great, and I know you're gonna accomplish all of your dreams, and I will be rooting for you every step of the way.
Hi, Prof Sarver, it's Brian, and I just wanna give you an immense thank you for everything. For Lion Witch Wardrobe, for Hiding Place, for Shakespeare, for everything. The first time that I got to meet you, God gave me the assurance that this was the school I was meant to go to, and this was the place I was meant to belong. And you have made sure that that was the case. I have never felt like I have belonged in any theater department before, let alone even high school or any school. But being here, you've made it a home. And I'm eternally grateful for that. You have washed your love over both me and also the rest of the department and the students. You've given wisdom and creativity and your brilliance that God has blessed you with in so many ways over the years. And I am so grateful. You are amazing. You are incredible. And you deserve every part of the dream that God is giving back to you. We love you, and we are forever grateful. You're the best.